Mm-hmm. And I think wherever the chief minister is in touch with people, if you lose touch with people and you get captured, if you're a political leader, then we know what is happening to many of our political leaders at this point of time, when you get isolated by a coterie. But Nitish Kumar is not like that. He's got an open house.
And his development agenda has also worked in terms of numbers this time in the election. But, you know, Sanjay Singh, if I have to ask you, you travel different states for different state assembly elections. If I have to ask you to compare Bihar, when you were traveling in Bihar, with any other state, you know, for example, when you're traveling in Maharashtra or Haryana for state assembly election, how's it any different?
See, it saddens to somebody who is also from Bihar. But then the fact remains that there is no doubt Bihar has progressed in the last 10 years. If you compare Bihar with any other state, Bihar's capital, Patna, with any other state capital, I think that would not be a fair comparison. Precisely not because of historical reasons, not because of who is running the state, also because of the ruler's psyche that is there, the lethargyness of the administration, the way the people gradually started to think. What has actually transformed in last 10 years? Migration, the point that you are talking about Bihar, migration in Bihar starts at two levels. A, whosoever can afford, children of that particular family migrate from class 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then for graduation and various
courses. So for secondary as well as for higher education.
Yes. Those who cannot afford actually migrate from state, first individually and then with family, in search of some kind of livelihood.
Right.
Their peer group, their kins, their other relatives and their friends remain there. So the communication between state and with rest of the India is very, very strong, stronger than any other part than with Bihar.
Right.
Our job, Bihar, is to develop that particular state, because nobody actually wants to leave their state. And now there is also another problem. Now, since this narrative Bihari versus Bahari has come about, I don't know how this narrative pans out. That urge is there. Gradually there has been a change, and last 10 years that change is visible. But then the fact remains that if you strictly go by the economist number, Bihar would look like to be a paradise.
Right.
If you land there, actually move there, then you actually find that there are so many things that are lacking. The point that you are making, what challenges are there for Nitish Kumar? See, in last 10 years, Nitish Kumar was partner with, leave aside Jitendra Manjhi, he was a disaster as chief minister. Then Nitish Kumar's kind of fifth term, fourth term, when he came back for say last 8-9 months. Then again he was in election mode, so leave that aside. Take that 8 years. BJP was partner with Nitish Kumar. BJP was completely subservient to Nitish Kumar, and it was actually a Nitish Kumar government with his sign and seal to every, even to BJP party headquarters and the way candidates were selected and so on and so forth. In this particular case, he has less numbers than Lalu Prasad Yadav. His biggest challenge would be tame. I use the word tame because to Lalu Prasad Yadav, because Lalu is not somebody, he is not Sushil Kumar Modi, please remember. He is not other leaders who he was dealing with when BJP was in partner with
And their approach, their politics.
And also the Congress.
Right.
And also the Congress. Now Nitish Kumar has a huge challenge. Of course, he has, he is there, he is going to be five-time chief minister, taking oath as fifth time. But then the fact remains, his administrative capabilities are non-challengeable. But Nitish Kumar has never indulged in the kind of political management that he'll have.
But someone who has lived in Bihar when Lalu Prasad Yadav was the chief minister, and someone who has been in Bihar when Nitish Kumar was the chief minister, and now when both Nitish Kumar and Lalu Prasad Yadav are together, you know, if they have to compare, they will say the law and order situation was really bad during Lalu Yadav's time. It was controlled during Nitish Kumar. Now, are we heading towards lawlessness or law and order situation? Then, important challenges, road, you know, transport, health, education, how these issues will really pan out, and women and youth constituency, because as you rightly point, the aspirational voters who've actually voted for Nitish Kumar, they will want jobs, they will want how the farm income really goes up. How do you think Nitish Kumar tackle these challenges?
See, we should be optimistic about it. Nitish Kumar is a politician, a person who generally likes to take things heads on, but he is also a very pragmatic politician. He also knows as to survive with different kind of political streams and situations. he also will have an eye at the center in 2019, mind you. So, he will be constantly thinking his biggest challenge is to run his government till the time these parliamentary elections happen in 2019. That is his also somewhere.
Okay, you're calling him a strong contender for the post of
PM. He is now alternate prime minister candidate for 2019, provided he successfully runs his government till 2019. Now, the challenges that we are saying, the obviously somebody should be very positive about since this kind of mandate is there, and we should hope that Lalu Prasad Yadav's sons and daughters would kind of their new generation guys, and therefore should be kind of more adjustable to the aspirations and kind of hopes that Bihar had placed on them, and not just going by
what NK, Bihar is one state. When you travel, you know, from one distance to the another, the other distance, you measure the distance in terms of number of hours you will take to reach that distance in term instead of kilometers. And that's this, you know, sad paradox of you know, as far as connectivity is concerned, transport. What sort of challenges you think at this stage? Because let's not forget, you are working here with a very, very, you know, this is going to be a very difficult coalition with the RJD and law and order, women, youth. How do you, you know, manage all of this?
That's a very good question, but one correction. Now that is not the situation. Road population ratio has drastically improved with the result, and radial roads in particular. I won't say arterial roads, but roads by and large, connectivity is very good. So is electricity. When I got married some 38 years ago, when I went there to for marriage, my father-in-law, in a begging sense, he said, "Ab to yahan pe bijli khamba lag gaya, ab to bijli aa jayegi." For remaining 35 years, there was no electricity, aur wo khamba gir gaya. But 3 years ago, there was khamba again, and there was bijli, and still every day I call up and find that the bijli aa rahi hai. It's not that bijli was generated there. PLF is very poor. Plant load factor is very poor. There is no extra generation, but Nitish is importing power. And that is one redeeming aspect. So connectivity is fine. And that besides is why he is getting third term. So in what happens that if your GDP is, state GDP is going up, this basic theory, I think Professor will bear me out on this. You should go into direct delivery. Transfer your cash. Nitish gave cycle. Nitish gave roads. That sustained him for the past 10 years. But now I say there is a problem in Bihar situation. When we analyze Bihar, population density of Bihar is 3 times higher than national average. That's national average is 365. And Bihar's population density is 1100. So there is a pressure on land. What will Nitish
do? And that is not easily available also.
Very, I mean, all out of 100 murders that take place, 80 are committed on account of land dispute.
True.
So you can imagine the social strife. So therefore, development is a challenge, of course. But the easiest part of it for a state apparatus is that if it really intends to deliver, within 1 kilometer, it can get so much of population. Once the Madhya Pradesh chief minister told me, no, every time you are comparing
me. The serious development challenges for the new government, as a renowned social scientist has just said, that the biggest challenge before the new government is to change the perception about Bihar. Whether the new establishment will be successful in changing the perception about Bihar, that remains to be seen. But time now for me to slip into a short break. In our final segment, we'll try and understand the important challenges for the central government from here. Bold economic reforms, what really happened to all of that? Stay tuned.
परमात्मने नमः।
एक बिंदु जिसमें समाया है ब्रह्मांड, अणु से अनंत तक अस्तित्व खोजता इंसान, तनाव मुक्त मस्तिष्क, रोग मुक्त शरीर, शांत चित्त, स्वस्थ और सुखी जीवन, संभव है ये सब। कैसे, जानने के लिए देखिए योग निरोग हर रविवार सुबह 8 बजे लोकसभा टीवी पर।